हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल वी डिस्कस अबाउट एसे राइटिंग। आज हम एसे राइटिंग के बारे में बात करेंगे। ओके, पहले हम पढ़ेंगे व्हाट इज एन एसे। एसे क्या है? एन एसे इज अ पीस ऑफ राइटिंग यूजली शॉर्ट एंड इन प्रोज ऑन एनी वन सब्जेक्ट। इट इज़ अ स्पेसीज ऑफ प्रोज कंपोजिशन लेस इलाबोरेट बट कंप्लीट इन इट्सेल्फ। डॉक्टर जॉनसन डिफाइंस द एसे एज अ लूज सेली ऑफ द माइंड एन इरेगुलर इनडाइजेस्टेड पीस नॉट अ रेगुलर एंड ऑर्डरली परफॉर्मेंस। देखिए, एफ एच पिचर्ड ने कहा है रिकॉर्ड्स इट एज एन अटेम्प्ट ब्रीफ एंड फ्रेगमेंट्री बट ऑलवेज सिंसियर टू एक्सप्रेस अ प्रॉब्लम इन टर्म्स ऑफ वंस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी। यहाँ पर देखिए एक डेफिनेशन और है जो कि ऑक्सफोर्ड इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी की तरफ से की गई है। ऑक्सफोर्ड इंग्लिश डिक्शनरी ने एक्सप्लेन किया है अ कंपोजिशन ऑफ मॉडरेट लेंथ ऑन एनी पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट और ब्रांच ऑफ अ सब्जेक्ट ओरिजिनली इम्प्लाइंग वांट ऑफ फिनिश बट नाउ सेड ऑफ अ कंपोजिशन मोर और लेस इलाबोरेट इन स्टाइल दो लिमिटेड इन रेंज। टू हर्डसन ने भी कहा है, हर्डसन ने भी ये डेफिनेशन दी है। इट इज़ अ कंपोजिशन ऑन एनी टॉपिक द चीफ नेगेटिव फीचर्स ऑफ विच आर कंपरेटिव ब्रेविटी एंड कंपरेटिव वांट ऑफ एक्सॉस्टिवनेस। नेक्स्ट हम पढ़ेंगे फॉर्मल फीचर्स ऑफ एन एसे। फर्स्ट है हमारा सब्जेक्ट एंड पहले हम फॉर्मल फीचर्स पढ़ लेंगे एसे के। द अबव एग्जांपल्स विल सफिश टू शो हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज टू इम्प्रिजन द एमोरफस लाइफ ऑफ द एसे। ओके, इन द आयरन बॉक्स ऑफ मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला इट्स आउटलाइन आर सो अनसर्टेन एंड इट वेरियस सो मच इन मैटर पर्पज एंड स्टाइल दैट अ सिस्टमेटिक ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ इट इज एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट इफ नॉट impossible. The term essay has been so loosely used that an attempt to fix its formal features may end in a failure. However, the essential qualities of the essay which seem on the whole to be fairly general may be marked out on the basis of the statements and observations made on the essay from time to time. Okay, अब हम formal features के बारे में इन topics को थोड़ा सा एक्सप्लेन कर लेते हैं। फर्स्ट है सब्जेक्ट एंड रेंज। द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द एसे मे बी एनीथिंग लो और हाई स्मॉल और ग्रेट इट मे बी द एटम और द सिस्टम द फॉल ऑफ अ स्पैरो और द डेथ ऑफ द यूनिवर्स हु वॉकर राइटली रिमार्क्स apparently there is no subject from the stars to the dust heap and from the amoeba to man which may not be dealt with in essay. Neither in respect of manner of treatment is the change much less wide. An essayist is calmly observant and with a sense of humor. He muses on things as they are. The most trivial occurrences serve to set him a dreaming. Thoughts irresponsible and unbidden come straying into his consciousness. With a sure and light touch, he sets down these fancies in gentle prose to soothe, to charm, and to encourage his fellow. Second, our clarity of thought. His fanciful musing and rambling dreams soon crystallize into clear thoughts and ideas like vapors into raindrops, is dispelled like the mist of the morning and the first streaks of light down upon the surface of his consciousness. Some surmises, guesses, misgivings, dim instincts, embryo conceptions. It is fly off like the imaginary fears of a night rambler in the daylight. Wakan, Addison, Lamb, Gardiner, and many others write on the subjects of their choice with the utmost confidence and clarity of thought. They focus the light of their thoughts on the objects of their discussion in such a way that their threadbare analysis become almost transparent to the reader. Next, hamara brevity. Brevity is the soul of all animated writing. Since the essay is a fragment, everything relating to the object of discussion is to be compressed within the limited space. If the essay grows in bulk and comprehensiveness, it becomes a treatise of dissertation like Sir Thomas Browne's Religio Medici. Next, incompleteness. This essay being an attempt on a subject implies want of finish. Since it is not a thorough and final examination of a subject, it is complete within itself. Though small in size, it is well woven and rounded off with an artistic touch. Okay. Like an atom, it is small but complete in its own way. Next, a ill-defined plot. Just as the size and shape of an atom is uncertain, similarly, the plot of the essay is fluid. Like water, the essay has no shape of its own. Just as water takes the shape of a pot in which it is contained. Similarly, the subjects of an essay determines its forms and structure. Next, a considerable amount of freedom. This essay offers a considerable amount of freedom to the writer in handling of the subject. The essayist is at his liberty in adjusting the material introduced and the method employed in the dealing with it. He chooses his set of tools to work upon the material of his choice and then allow his fancy to tickle to it. Next, an exercise in self-restraint. But the freedom enjoyed by the essayist in handling the material and adjusting the method is the freedom of a master, not of a slave. The writing of an essay is an exercise in self-restraint. The essayist feels the obligation of selection and rejection, preferences and avoidance. He deals with his instrument. He has a sense of self-restraint and renunciation. Okay. Last, hamara stamp of one's personality. This essay being an individual attempt on the subject of one's choice, wears on it an unmistakable stamp of the personality of a writer. The image of his personality is projected in the way of expression and arrangement of each and every word. That is to say, the style is the man, his moods, likes, dislikes, preferences, and tastes. All are printed in his words. His prose compositions are the true mirrors of his mind and soul. एडवर्ड गिवन appropriately remarks, ये एडवर्ड गिवन एक राइटर हैं, द स्टाइल ऑफ एन ऑथर शुड बी द इमेज ऑफ हिज माइंड, द फंक्शन ऑफ द एसे द फंक्शन ऑफ पोइट्री इज टू इंस्ट्रक्ट एंड टू डिलाइट, द फंक्शन ऑफ अ प्रोज कंपोजिशन इज टू परस्यूट. आर इज कॉट जेम्स Aptly remarks about the function of the essay. For to instruct and to delight, that throughout the centuries had been the admitted aim of the poet, and to persuade, that was the object of the orator or writer of prose. If prose composition offers us some information about the subject, it teaches us, gives us some knowledge. De Quincey calls it roughly the literature of knowledge. Okay, the world better the science of the instrument he plays on, perhaps after all with the freedom which in such case will be freedom of a master. He says that simplest and the most direct and exact manner possible, but with no surplusage.